President Trump now preparing our troops to guard the southern border until the wall is complete. It's a major step in tightening immigration laws and cracking down on border protection. Joining me now to discuss, Michael Pregent, former intelligence advisor to General Petraeus, former military intelligence officer, also Hudson Institute fellow, and Gina Loudon, political analyst, and Donald J. Trump for President Advisory Board member. Gina, I just want to start with you because I think one of the things that may have hastened this is probably a two-pronged thing. Not getting anywhere with respect to the border wall from either side of the aisle, really. And then, you know, images of this caravan coming up from Mexico of Honduras citizens who are being allowed to travel to our southern border. And many people are saying that it represents not only a danger, but it sends an even more dangerous message.
Yeah, I think that, you know, this is the number one job of the president, and that is to secure our country. National security is the number one job of the president. This is also the number one reason, Charles, at least in the top two or three, that most Americans who did vote for him voted for him. So this is about him keeping a campaign promise to the American people that our borders will be secure, and that's going to be by any means necessary. And I think most Americans are really glad to hear it, contrary to what you might hear in the rest of the media.
You know, Michael, we do know that the Border Patrol, the esprit de corps, was at perhaps a record low going into last year. And while it's up, all the Border Patrol agents I speak to say they need help and that they're in a sort of dire straits. Could this be the right bridge until we get to perhaps a wall?
Absolutely. I'm from El Paso, Texas. I have relatives in U.S. Customs and also the Border Patrol that didn't vote for Trump, but yet are happy about what he's doing. And this is an absolute good use of the National Guard to actually deploy them to the border. And again, the messaging to Mexico about NAFTA should be resonating as well. I wouldn't be surprised if Mexico starts to siphon off this group of people that are heading towards our border, because I do believe the president is very serious about this.
And there's some other arrows in that quiver, including perhaps taxing remittance, which would be a heck of a blow. Let me ask you real quick, because we're crunching on time, but Michael, first to you, pulling troops out of Syria. We understand that President Trump is not about nation building. He promised to bring the troops home. They've been overworked, overtaxed in our effort to keep the peace there. But is it a wise idea right now?
No, the president can't criticize President Obama for leaving Iraq early and giving rise to ISIS. The president can't declare a premature victory over ISIS in Iraq and Syria and leave. We're already seeing security backsliding in Iraq, and we're starting to see it in Syria as the SDF moves to protect YPG forces west of the Euphrates. So we should stay, kill ISIS, and also start curbing what Iran is doing in both Iraq and
Syria.
Gina,
though, that's a tall order, and this is how we've got sucked into that region for a long time already.
Yeah, the president has learned a lot by our mistakes in the past, and especially the mistakes under the last administration. And he's not going to let those things happen, Charles. Rest assured, the president has a solid plan. And I believe, just like most things the president does, as it unfolds, Americans will begin to understand that this was solid and will work.
Thank you both very much. Thank you at home. And now, here's Lou Dobbs.